I'm Rudy Lopez, the director of your Washington State Veterans Cemetery and a past chair of the Eastern Washington Veterans Task Force, and it is my distinct honor to MC today's service. And at this time, if you are able, please stand for the presentation of colors by the Fairchild Air Force Base Color Guard, followed by the National Anthem, the Korean National Anthem, and the invocation by Chaplain Jerry Malone.
Present. Arms.
Thank you.
Sern Hartsch.
Let's pray. Lord God Almighty, it's this day, June 27th, 1950, so many years ago, was it 72 years, the Korean War started. And today, as we dedicate this Spokane Memorial, we bow our hearts to you. We remember these very special persons, even in our area of Spokane, some 40 lost their lives. They were created in your image, and they were loved by you, Lord. They're warriors from our city. They answered the commander-in-chief's call. They listened to the nations, to the nation. They listened to their hearts. They leaned on you, Almighty, and they fought at the distant barricade far from our shores, and they died in battle. And we stopped the push and the shove for just a few moments today. And Lord, in your presence, we are still. We know that you are God and you are sovereign. We remember as our thoughts reflect back in that time. For many of us, it's just a history lesson, but for some here, it's so real. That those who died for our democracy and freedom had mothers and fathers, they had brothers, sister, they had grandparents, they had a cousin, they had aunts and uncles, a girlfriend, maybe a spouse. They had friends they just finished school with, dozens of acquaintances all left behind, all who muffled their tears to the public's eye over this horrible loss in their life. And through their lives, they carried pockets full of grief and anguish day by day and week by week, year by year, often stopping whatever they were doing, singed by the red-hot memory. Oh, God, how I miss him. Oh, God, how empty I feel. So today, we have gratitude in our hearts, Lord, for those who served, the support organizations, the warriors, their families who live on. We thank you, Lord, and it's good to give thanks. You are a God of love and mercy. It's good to give thanks. To gaze on these hard stones is a sort of soft healing for wounded souls. In your precious name we pray. Amen.
Y'all may be seated. Thank you, Chaplain Malone, for those inspiring and uplifting words. What a pleasure it is to be with you today. A year ago, we dedicated this monument on another beautiful day. It happened to be the hottest day in 2021. And this happens to be the hottest day of the year in 2022 so far. But it's a very pleasant day. So we're grateful that you all could join us today. I would like to welcome some dignitaries that are here with us today. And I think we should only fittingly start with Korean War vets. Do we have any Korean War veterans? I know we have a couple of them in attendance. If you're able to, please stand or raise your hand so we can acknowledge you. Also joining us today is U.S. Congressional Representative Kathy McMorris Rogers from the 5th Legislative District, the Honorable Nadine Woodward, Mayor of Spokane, ma'am. The Consul General, Republic of Korea, Seo Eun-ji. The Executive Director, Seattle VA Regional Office, was going to join us today, but I think he was detained. And Mr. Song H. Kim, President of the Peaceful Unification Advisory Council of Seattle Municipal Chapter, as well as Mr. Jack Fallis, Global Credit Union CEO. Thank you, Jack, for being with us today. And Sergeant First Class Myung Hee Han, Republic of Korea Army, who served from August of 1950 to November of 1954, serving alongside of our American brothers in arms. So thank you all for being with us today. At this time, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Heather Boehm, who is the chairperson of the Eastern Washington Veterans Task Force. It is the state of Washington's oldest serving Veterans Advisory Council, been in existence well over 40 years, and Heather has the privilege of chairing that group. Heather, will you join us for remarks?
Good afternoon, everybody, and thank you for taking time out of your day to come and help us dedicate this amazing monument that you guys all see behind me. And to all the veterans that are here, especially our Korean War veterans, I'm humbled just to be here for you guys. The reality is I don't think my remarks need to be long. I don't think they even need to be as impactful as the fact that what I'm standing in front of honestly can speak for itself. And all the hours that went into it, it was just our honor to actually be able to work with individuals to make it come to fruition so that we could be here today to say thanks. Our veterans left our shores to go and defend freedom, something that we get to experience every day to make sure that, you know, what we get, you know, Korea gets as well for South Korea. So I just want to thank you for your time. And as a veteran myself, I'm just humbled. I served 22 years, and honestly, my 22 years are a small comparison to the great thank you that I feel every day that I have to continue to serve. So please enjoy. I just don't even have words. The task force spent a lot of hours trying to kind of, it was about a 5-year commitment to actually get to where we are today. So I wish we had more task force members here, but the fact of the matter is I see a few of them out here in the audience and they took time out of their day as well. So I think, Rudy, who's the next one? Oh, okay. Thanks. Thank you.
Thank you, Heather. At this time, I would like to introduce the Mayor Woodward, the Spokane Veterans Task Force, dedicated a number of years to this project, as Heather mentioned, and it was through the support of the city, work with the Public Facilities District, that this project came into fruition. And now it's a reality, and we'd like to dedicate this and give this to the city of Spokane, as well as site it here at the PFD, where it's a place of honor alongside of other monuments. So, ma'am, would you please join us for your remarks?
Well, thank you, Rudy, and thank you all for being here today. Very special, special occasion for the city of Spokane. War, any war, is devastating. The loss of life and the difficulties still faced by those who returned home reverberate for generations. Looking around today and seeing the memorials, I'm reminded of the loss that war brings, the sadness, the pain, and the unwavering valor, the duty, and fortitude of those who serve. The Korean War has been called the Forgotten War, its purpose and its devastation largely going unrecognized. No war should ever be forgotten, minimized, or pushed aside. The conflict, the devastation, and the steps taken to rebuild should always be remembered and honored, and so that is why I am so glad you're all here today. We owe a lasting debt of gratitude to all of those who fought against communism, who fought in extreme conditions, and who fought to preserve freedoms. We must remember forever the nearly 5 million people who lost their lives during the war, over half of whom were civilians. The 600,000 Allied troops, the 40,000 Americans who died, the 100,000 who were wounded, the 122,000 Washingtonians who honorably served, and the 388 individuals who did not return. We must never forget their profound sacrifice and their service, their duty to protect the ideals that we all hold so dear. The Korean War Veterans Memorial recognizes those sacrifices of those service members, their families, and also the support of the community in preserving peace, freedom, and prosperity. The monument will permanently stand as a lasting symbol of gratitude alongside other veteran memorials, forgotten no more. Thank you.
thank you, Mayor Woodward, for your support of this project and for sharing your thoughts behind this important monument to the city. Joining us on this special occasion, we're honored to have So Eun-ji, Consul General, Republic of Korea. Ma'am, thank you for traveling from Seattle. She is the first Consul General from her nation, and we understand that you've been in that position for just about 100 days. So welcome to Spokane and Washington State. Ma'am, will you please join us for remarks?
Dear Korean War veterans and families, U.S. Representative Kathy McMorris Rogers, Ms. Nadine Udall, Mayor Spokane, Mr. Rudy Lopez, Washington Veterans Cemetery Director, Mr. Heather Bain, Eastern Washington Veterans Task Force Chair, Mr. Won Taek Shin, President of the Korean American Association of the Spokane Area, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. Today, we are gathered here to remember and honor the heroes who sacrificed their lives for the freedom and peace of the Republic of Korea during the Korean War. First and foremost, I'd like to pay tribute to the Korean War veterans who fought on the brutal front lines of the war. I also extend my sincerest condolences to the bereaved family members who have buried their loved one in their hearts for over 70 years. The Korean War Veterans Memorial, built here in Spokane in June 2021, is an incredibly meaningful monument created by the joint efforts of many organizations and Korean communities. It is a true symbol of the legacy of the Korean War and the longstanding ironclad alliance between two countries. Taking this opportunity, I especially want to convey my special thanks to the members of the Eastern Washington Veteran Task Force, Korean community organizations, and Spokane City authorities for putting their best efforts into completing the Korean War Memorial. As we witness the war in Ukraine now, it reminds us again of the sacrifice and devotion shown by young people around the world choosing to show up and fight in a foreign land for a worthy cause. 72 years ago, they willingly crossed the Pacific Ocean to protect people they never met in a country they had never heard of. Unfortunately, the U.S. veteran from Spokane was the first American brave soul to risk his life fighting in the Korean Peninsula. The United States was the country that had to endure the greatest sacrifice, losing 36,000 young servicemen and women in the war, including 532 from the state of Washington. By now, Korean government has awarded the Ambassador for Peace medals as an expression of appreciation to American servicemen and women who served in the Korean War. Today, I feel very honored to award the commemorative medals to those two unsung heroes, Marvin L. Watson and Kenneth W. Anderson, on behalf of the Republic of Korea. With the recent inauguration of the newest Korean administration, the U.S.-Korea summit was held within the fastest time ever. The alliance between our two countries expanding and developing beyond the security and economic alliance and into technology and global strategic alliance. With our strengthening relations, the Korean War will not be a forgotten war, but we forever remembered by the freedom and peace that has been rooted in the Republic of Korea. Once again, I speak on behalf of our government and people when I say our memories of gratitude and respect will continue forever. Thank you very much.
Ma'am, thank you for those heartfelt words. We have the honor of having Congresswoman Kathy McMorris Rogers join us today. The Congresswoman has been a stalwart advocate of veterans community in Eastern Washington throughout her time in office. Ma'am, it is a pleasure to have you join us today to dedicate this lasting tribute to the men and women who so selflessly served in the Korean War. Ma'am, will you please join us?
Good morning. Thank you, Rudy, for all you do to honor and remember our veterans. A big thank you to all the veterans, the service members, the families that are here today to pay tribute to those who served. I see some friendly faces from a year ago, and it brings me such joy. It was a beautiful ceremony, and it's great to be with everyone again this morning. Today we gather to honor a debt that we can never repay. The service and the sacrifice of the brave men and women who served during the Korean War. While this conflict is often referred to as the Forgotten War, our being here today to dedicate this beautiful memorial is proof that we will always remember those who fought for our freedom. Together, we're renewing our commitment to remember the nearly 7 million Americans who served in Korea and the 54,000 who never made it back home, including 42 that called Spokane home. I've long believed that when someone joins the military, it's not just a job. It's a commitment, and it's a family commitment to our country. My hope is that this memorial will be a place of peace for the families and the loved ones who've served in the war, and that it will foster an atmosphere of reflection for everyone in our community. While we will never be able to repay the debt we owe them, my hope is that this memorial will serve as a permanent reminder of the sacrifices they made for us. As we dedicate it today, let us also recognize the countless hours that went into making this special memorial possible. Thank you to the Eastern Washington Veterans Task Force, the ladies and gentlemen of the Washington State Veterans Cemetery for your tremendous work. Thank you to all that were a part of making sure that we could preserve the legacy of those who served before us, driven by honor, duty, and country, and ensure that generations to come understand these heroes were willing to sacrifice everything to protect our freedom. Today, let us renew our promise to never forget their courage and honor their fight to preserve peace, freedom, and prosperity in the United States of America. Thank you, and God bless.
Thank you, ma'am, for those heartfelt words. At this time, we would like to present two wreaths to dedicate this monument, if we can have the military prepare those. And they will be brought forward by our dignitaries today, ma'am. You may be seated. If I may, I'm going to go off script. I've got one presentation to Mr. Jack Fallis with Global Credit Union. If you can come forward, Jack. Global Credit Union was one of our two primary sponsors for this event. There's absolutely no way projects like this can get off the ground without the financial support of individuals and organizations within their communities. And Global Credit Union has proven themselves time and time again to be stalwart supporters of the veteran and military community. So we wanted to commemorate your efforts with this plaque.
Thank you, Rudy. I appreciate that.
We also have one for the David Condon family. They were the primary sponsors and the very first ones to get this this project funded. There are many, many other organizations that assisted us. I don't want to miss any one of them, so if you look at the back of your programs, we've listed all of our sponsors on the back. Once again, we could not have done this without the financial backing and donations that came forward, gifts in kind, by a number of organizations to make this possible, so thank you. This will conclude today's ceremony. The Korean American Association would like to invite everyone for lunch. That's a nice thing, right? So if you'd like to join us, it's going to be held at VFW Post 51, which is just off the corner of Washington and Mission. So thank you once again for attending today's ceremony and helping us honor those individuals who today are forgotten no more. One of those includes my father.